Dear Mr. Gable, I am writing this to you, and I hope that you will read it so you'll know. My heart beats like a hammer, and I stutter and I stammer every time I see you at the picture show. I guess I'm just another fan of yours, and I thought I'd write and tell you so. You made me love you. I didn't want to do it. I didn't want to do it. You made me love you. And all the time you knew it. I guess you always knew it. You made me happy sometimes. You made me glad. But there were times, sir, you made me feel so sad. You made me sigh, 'cause I didn't want to tell you. I didn't want to tell you. The very mention of your name sends my heart reeling. For you know you made me love you. Oh, gee, Mr. Gable, I guess you got a lot of girls that tell you the same thing. And if you don't want to read this well, you don't have to. But I just had to tell you about the time I saw you, and it happened one night. Well, that was the first time I ever saw you, and right then I knew you were the best girl in the movies. I guess it was because you acted so, well, so natural-like. Not like a real actor at all, but just like any fella you meet at school. Party, party. One time I saw you in a movie with Joan Crawford, and I had to cry a little, because you loved her so much. And you couldn't have her. Well, not till the end of the picture anyway. And then one time I saw you in person. Well, yeah, you were going to the Coconut Grove and I was standing there when you got out of your car. You almost knocked me down. Oh, but it wasn't your fault. I was in the way. Well, you looked at me and you smiled. Well, yeah, you smiled right at me as if you meant it. And I cried all the way home just because you smiled at me for being in your way. Oh, honest, didn't you? Mr. Gable, you're my favorite actor. Well, I don't care what happens.